works area. We'll just keep that a quick dry. Switch the 3/4 inch flat. And next to that, there's a little building. Just it's like on the top of a hill as it looks down the looks down into the little valley. A little chimney on there, and there's a little extension on the side. Sit there. I'm leaving a little highlighted area just to add a little bit of interest, and that just continues down into something around there.
For that.
Now this area around here, I'm just going back into the dark mix again, maybe a touch of light of lemon yellow. I'm just going to pull this across, a bit more lemon yellow I think. In fact, I'm going to clean the brush, I want it a lot lighter than that. Raw sienna and lemon yellow. Pull that down just so it's light, it's just so it contrasts with the dark building. Leave those white highlighted areas. Maybe a touch of light red, only a touch. That's too much I think. No, that'll do, that's alright. And then we've got a really dark area. As that dips down, and we're into as that comes down now, and we're into shadows. And that sort of disappears up towards the horizon. And over here, we've just got the outline. You can just see the outline of the tree. Scraping some effects. What I'll do first, because the paper's stretched, I'm just going to pull it tight again so we've got a flat surface to work with. Now I'll just scrape in twigs and branches and what have you. Now on this right hand side, I'm going to go back into the dark. Burnt umber, ultramarine, nice and dark. I'm just going to put, we've got another building on this side here. I'm just going to put that in. All that there. Back into the dark mix. Just stick a little chimney on the top there. And there's another one a little bit further along. Bit like that.